Well, good morning and welcome to our Sabbath School class today for our science demonstration. It's entitled, Playing with Fire and Not Getting Burnt. Maybe you remember when you were younger, maybe those of you who are young now, you've heard your mother, your father say, don't play with fire, you'll get burnt. And that really is usually true. But we have a text we want to look at today. It's in Isaiah chapter 33 and verse 14. And it's in our second slide, if you have the slides. And it says this. The sinners in Zion are afraid. Fearfulness has surprised the hypocrites. Who among us shall dwell with the devouring fire? Who among us shall dwell with everlasting burnings? Now, for our science experiment today, we have to warn you, do not do this at home. We're going to post the video on YouTube, so you can watch this later or share it with your friends later, but do not try this at home. This is only for professionals. I'm not sure why we're doing it here, but as I say, don't try this at home, or someone else says, try it at someone else's home. For this demonstration, you're going to need access to methane or propane gas. Either one will work. Methane gas is CH4, propane is C3H8. You're going to need, and we'll pan over here to these items if we could, and down. We're going to need access to a plastic jar. You want to make sure you have a fire extinguisher around. You're going to need some dish soap. We're going to need a pan of water. We're going to need safety glasses because safety first. And we're going to need a striker, among other things. Now, there's other items that we can use in this. You need some rubber tubing, and I have some rubber tubing actually back here because I have some propane gas here. And I have a piece of rubber tubing that is just the right size to go over an adapter we have here that goes on that can to a little camp stove. We have the lighter mentioned. Okay, and so we have basically everything that we need here. Now, if we go to the next slide, slide number 6, it says, do not try this at home. Do not try this at home. Now, what we're going to do is, and I'll just go ahead and explain what we're going to do now. So, Mike, if you want to get the camera set here, we're going to do the experiment about right here, I think. Okay? And I think we can do this. What we're going to do is we drill a hole. Anyhow, we have a hole drilled in our jug. And through that hole, I'm going to drop this hose. And I could have put it straight in, but I have a reason for not doing that. And so we're going to put this down in here, and I have a special can to hold that up a little higher there. I hope that works. Yep, just about like that. And what we're going to do, we're going to ask Raquel to come up now, and you take your other glasses off and put your safety glasses on for us. Now, which hand do you use the least?
My left hand.
Okay, then you want to roll up this left sleeve.
Is that a safety precaution?
That's a safety precaution. We wouldn't want to hurt your good hand. And what we're going to do, we're going to expel some gas into this special solution that is water with some dishwashing detergent. And I actually put a little red food dye in it just to give it a little coloration. But we're going to turn some bubbles on and make bubbles. And you'll be able to see the bubbles are starting to rise up into the container. And what I want you to do is I want you to dip your hand now very well into this water and your wrist. Okay? Make sure you get it completely wet, the whole wrist area. Don't be afraid of it. It's just plain water. Okay? Now turn it over. Okay, now Raquel, what I want you to do now is get this bubble. Hurry before it grows off. Get it with your left hand. Okay, now I want you to hold those bubbles there. Watch this, Mike.
Oh my goodness. That was scary.
Did that scare you?
Yes.
Well, let's do it again. Let's put your other hand in water too this time. Let's get both hands really wet. And I want you to scoop them up and get a big scoop of bubbles for us with both hands. Now, you got to get the other hand wet, too. Because if it's not wet, yeah, that's right. Okay, come on, get this big thing of bubbles here.
Oh, my God. It's going to burn me.
It's not going to burn anything. Wasn't she brave? Wasn't she brave? Aren't you proud of Raquel? Okay, thank you, Raquel. We'll let you stop at that one. And just so that you know that I am a good sport about this, I'll reach in here and get some of these bubbles and say, flame on. And there they are. What do you think about that? Playing with fire and not getting burnt. Oh, Mother wouldn't be very proud of me today for doing all this, would she? But we'll see if we can get a few more of those good gas bubbles that have got caught by the soap bubbles. And it just burns like that. Isn't that something? And we'll explain a little bit about what's happened here. And remember, do not try this at home. Why does this work? The water covering the hands protects them from the quick burning fire. As the water is heated, it begins to evaporate. And evaporation is a cooling process. So the water acts as a barrier between your hand and the fire. Plus, as it starts to evaporate, it actually has a cooling effect and it keeps your hand from being burned. If Raquel had not put her hands in the water first and had just grabbed the soap bubbles, she would have gotten burnt. I would have too. But remember, don't try this at home. Do not try this at home. Now, Isaiah 33, verse 14 asks, it says, who among us shall dwell with the devouring fire? Who among us shall dwell with everlasting burnings? But the answer is given in the next verse, in verse 15. It says, he that walketh righteously and speaketh uprightly, he that despises the gain of oppression, that shaketh his hands from holding of bribes, that stoppeth his ears from hearing of blood and shutteth his eyes from seeing evil. Those are the people, those people who have that kind of a righteous character that will be able to stand amidst the devouring burning fire. Can you think of some faithful believers who lived in devouring fire? Can you think of any?
Yes.
Who?
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. In slide number 16, we see a picture of a furnace, and there's four outlines of figures in there. But there was a fourth person in that fire. In Daniel chapter 3, we know that King Nebuchadnezzar had built this great image, something probably like the image he saw in his dream in chapter 2. But instead of making it of different metals, he made it all of what?
Gold.
All of gold. And that was to represent him and his kingdom extending on forever. And he wasn't too idealistic to the idea that his kingdom would change or leave him. But he built this image and he brought in all the people from his province to bow down to it. But Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego would not bow down to it. And he said, if you don't bow down, into the hot furnace you go. And they said, so king, we are not careful to answer you in this matter. No matter what you say, no matter what your enticement or bad thing is, we're not going to bow down. And so he sent them into the furnace, heated seven times hotter than normal. And yet they weren't singed. There was not even the smell of smoke upon them. And Nebuchadnezzar said, I see one, a fourth, low like this. Who? The Son of God. And we know this was Jesus who personally came to walk with them in that fire. And when they came out, none of their clothes was burnt. They weren't, the hairs of their hand weren't even singed. And there was no smell on them or anything. And Jesus had been with them. God protected Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And he can protect us too. Not only from physical harm, from physical fire, but from the fiery darts of the wicked. Remember in Ephesians 6:16, the Apostle Paul mentions the fiery darts of the wicked. But how does God do this? In that same verse, he says, with the shield of faith. But it's not only the fiery darts of the wicked, but Peter tells us of fiery trials. In 1 Peter 4:12, it says, beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial, which is to try you as though some strange thing happened unto you. And so we may have fiery trials as well that come our way, but we can survive by the grace of God. Now we have one more just little short demonstration. If maybe I put, look here. Put it here. Now, I would do this with a $100 bill, but I don't have the $100 bill, you know. But I'm rich enough to have a $20 bill today. So what I'm going to do I'm going to take this little bowl here. And in this bowl I have a little bit, but I'm going to pour just a little more. I'm going to pour some rubbing alcohol in it. And this is 70% isopropyl alcohol, so it's not 100% alcohol. That means it's mixed with some water. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to dip this $20 bill in. Do you think that'd be okay to do? And we're going to take this $20 bill now. We're going to burn it up. It's going to burn it up. But you notice, except for where I was holding it slightly there, it's still here. Why? Even though it was burning, because of the water. You see, the water protected it. There was water mixed in here. So the alcohol burned very quickly, but the water protected it. And as it was evaporating, it was cooling the bill down. Isn't that nice? So sometimes the Lord sends us fiery trials. He lets us have them. But He gives us the water, the anointing of His Spirit to keep us. Peter tells us that when we have fiery trials, to rejoice inasmuch as ye are partakers of Christ's sufferings, that when His glory shall be revealed, you may be glad also with exceeding joy. God protected Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and He can protect us too if we have that fourth person with us. That was Jesus. He is the key. In Psalms 33:20, it says, "Our soul waiteth for the Lord. He is our helper and our shield." And remember, the Apostle Paul talked about the shield of faith that in Ephesians chapter 6. And what was that verse? 16. Ephesians 6:16. That with the shield of faith we could be protected from all the fiery darts of the wicked one. Very soon a time of trouble is coming upon this earth, and we will need the Lord to show us at that time. And let's read Daniel chapter 12 and verse 1.
Daniel chapter 12 verse 1. "And at that time shall Michael stand up, the great prince which standeth for the children of thy people. And there shall be a time of trouble such as never was since there was a nation, even to that same time. And at that time thy people shall be delivered, every one that shall be found written in the book."
Okay, thank you. So there's coming a time of trouble, and it's coming soon. But it says everyone who's written in God's book will be delivered at that time. He will be a strength and a shield to us. So if you have not given your life to Jesus, please do it today. And remember about this. Do try this at home. Give your life to Jesus at home or wherever you are. Well, thank you so much. And may God bless you lots and lots.